So in general, there's a couple of different philosophies. For those of you who play marimba, right? You play probably some kind of independent grip like this. If you play work grip, this probably doesn't apply so much, but if you play this grip, when you first learn that grip, you understand that when you play, one of the tricks is to try to play with one mallet and have the other mallet not move. You understand what I mean? That's one of the challenges that you realize. And so you quickly learn that if you hold the mallets tighter in your hand, that more of the mallets move. You also learn that the looser you hold it, the more that can stay still. So you quickly learn that to hold the stick in a loose sort of way, but you have the contact on the stick, will prevent it from bouncing back. So if you want to control the stick, right, you'll hold a loose grip, and you sort of catch the stick like you're hitting a pillow, right? So make sure that you're not fighting and squeezing the stick. So in general, we can keep like four basic rules. So when we're playing, it's important to keep your wrists below your beads. In other words, your wrists should be the thing that's anchored below. And when you're playing, if you can see from the side, that the wrist would be below where that beat is. So the general, right, would be basically like that. Most young players, if they have problems, if they try to get leverage over the drum like this, will eventually create a lot of problems for themselves. So in general, a good habit would be to keep your wrist anchored, right, so that you're actually lower onto the head from your wrist. Another thing would be the and this would be good for some of the players that I saw this morning, which is the order in which things happen is another thing that I think is important. So when you play, things happen from basically the front of the stick backwards, right?